Who gives this woman in marriage today?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing on this incredible day. We've gathered here to celebrate your greatest gift to us, which is love. Divine love comes to us from heaven, unites us together in relationships that are greater than any that we can imagine or encounter on our own. It is Justin and Bailey who have brought us all here today. What you have done through their lives in bringing them together, and what you are going to do through their lives in the future that we all imagine today. God, we invite you into this ceremony through the exchanging of vows that are given before witnesses and before you. Let all of us here feel the weight, importance, and sacred nature of this event. And we give you glory for all things, especially on this joyous occasion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It is marriage that brings us here. It is the relationship of Bailey and Justin, the love that they have shown and the love that they celebrate today. Bailey and Justin, if it is your intention on this day to exchange vows and be united as husband and wife, would you please join hands? Thank you. It's important for all of us here to remember that marriage is God's idea and not ours. When God first created human beings, when he created the first man, breathed life into his lungs and set him free in the garden, he looked down and saw that in spite of the beauty and grandeur around him, it was not good for him to be alone, and so he created woman. In that first relationship, as he took woman from man and designed them to be together forever, he gave us his plan and his guide for marriage. It is marriage that is the basis for all society. It is the basis for rearing of children, for creating life, and for being the people God created us to be. It's in marriage that we discover truly who we are, that we grow into the people that God designed us to be, and that we discover the true nature of who he is through Jesus Christ. What we are doing here is sacred before God the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. The words that are exchanged have eternal consequence, and that's why we enter into them with great reverence, as Bailey and Justin have decided to today. Something fundamental is changing here today. Justin and Bailey are becoming different. Justin walked in here merely as a son, as a brother, as a soldier, but he will leave here as a husband, and in so doing, he will fulfill his greatest role before God and before human beings. And Bailey walked in as a daughter and as a sister and as an athlete. But she will leave as a wife, fulfilling her greatest role before God in loving Justin as Christ has loved us. Through the time we spent together, from knowing Bailey in our church and from the time I spent with Justin to get to know him as a man, I was proud of both of them, of the devotion they've already shown to this relationship, of the patience that they've already shown in this relationships, and the longing that they have for one another. That is the basis and a foundation for a relationship that will extend beyond this day, and I am proud to say that I believe in them and in the vows that they will exchange. Our expectations of marriage are that it will bring us the greatest happiness in life, in knowing and being with those that we love. We will experience the greatest joys that we've ever imagined. From those dreams that we had as children, as young men and young women, we now enter into that adventure together. That's our expectation. But God's expectation is that through marriage, he will show us the greatest lessons of life. He will teach us what forgiveness truly means. He will teach us what patience truly means. He will teach us how to love as he loves us. And those lessons are not easy. They will take everything we have to get through them. And because of the challenge of marriage and because of the role we all share in Justin and Bailey's life, it's important that we understand that we're all here not just as spectators today, but as witnesses. You've been summoned to witness the exchange of vows and you all have the responsibility to hold them accountable to these vows today. The friends and family that stand on the stage with them today share the most important and significant roles in their life. You've chosen to be here in this circle as the closest witnesses to the vows they exchange. And because of your special role in their lives, you have a special responsibility to encourage them, to remind them of what happened here today, of how important it is, and how much they want it. If marriage were easy, then Justin and Bailey could stand here today and be joined simply by their affection and their promises. But because marriage is both hard and sacred, they will be joined in matrimony not by their promises nor by their affections, but by the vows they have written and that they will exchange now before all of these witnesses and Almighty God. Justin, would you go first in presenting to Bailey the vows that you've written?
I love you, Bailey. You're my best friend. Today I give myself to you in marriage. I promise to encourage you and inspire you. I promise to laugh and cry with you. I will comfort you in good times and in bad times, when life seems easy, when it seems hard. I promise to cherish you and to always hold you in the highest regard. These things I give to you today and all the days of our lives.
And now, Bailey, would you present to Justin these vows that you have written?
From this day forward, I promise to always love you. I promise to stand by your side through thick and thin. I promise to always be honest with you no matter what. I promise to support you in your dreams and aspirations. I promise to always be your best friend and help you see the joy in life. Nothing compares to the love I feel for you, and I promise to show you every day.
Rings give us a symbol to remember the promises that are made today. Something to adorn our bodies that never leave us. That when we see them and when others see them, they know and recognize that there is a vow that binds this person to another that is greater than heaven and earth. A ring is the circle, the symbol of what is infinite. And rings made of precious metals and stones, those things that least tarnish, symbolize the greatness of this bond between this man and woman. It's a reminder to themselves also, on those days when the love they feel right now seems far away. When they struggle, when they fight, when they are separated, they will look at these rings and remember the promises they made today. May I have the first ring? Thank you. Justin, would you take this ring and prepare to place it on Bailey's finger? And would you please repeat after me? Bailey, I give you this ring.
Bailey, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
As my wife.
As my wife.
Until I draw my last breath.
Until I draw my last breath.
Thank you, Justin. May I have the second ring? Thank you. Bailey, would you take this ring and place it upon Justin's finger, and in so doing, repeat after me. Justin, I give you this ring.
Justin, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
As my husband.
As my husband.
Until I draw my last breath.
Until I draw my last breath.
Amen. Unity is the central theme of Scripture, and it's a characteristic of God that we see played out and defined in the Trinity, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, three, yet three in one. In the Trinity, we see the inexplicable communion of relationship that God wants with us, three individuals in one. And just as in Scripture, God took a rib from Adam to create woman, and marriage between the two, they become one flesh. And so strong is the union that is made between Justin and Bailey right now that it may be inseparable. As a symbol of their commitment to this union, Justin and Bailey have chosen the tradition of unity sand. As they each combine their individual sands into the central container, it, like their lives, becomes something new. And just as those individual grains of sand could never be separated fully and effectively, so too are their lives now so combined in this moment into one flesh, blessed, celebrated, and sanctioned by God the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Justin and Bailey, would you pour the sand? Justin and Bailey, you've exchanged vows before these witnesses and God. You've exchanged rings as a symbol of those promises, and you've symbolized your love and union through the combination of the unity sand. Would you bow your heads now with me in inviting God's special blessing on this union that is here and now forever sanctioned? Almighty God, I pray through the name of Jesus Christ and by the power of the Holy Spirit that you would hold this marriage together, no matter what may come against it, no matter what may arise within it, I pray that you would strengthen it and hold it to endure throughout all of life's challenges. And God, I pray that those challenges would be far outnumbered by joys, by celebrations, by beauty, by life, and the triumph of these two finding one another and loving one another and refusing to give up on one another no matter what. God, I pray that all of us would recognize our responsibility to them, to love them, not through interfering, but by supporting, encouraging, and loving, and most of all, by praying for them. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Justin and Bailey, by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel and the state of Ohio, I pronounce you husband and wife. Justin, you may kiss your bride. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Sorge. Congratulations.
junior bridesmaids. Let's give it up for Tori and Shelby. All right, now let's make some noise for Maegan being escorted by Eric. And let's make some noise for Ashley being escorted by Jeremiah. And how about a warm welcome for Mara being escorted by Terry? And now put your hands together for Emily being escorted by Cody. Some noise for Victoria being escorted by Brad. And now a big round of applause for our maid of honor, Cheyenne, who's being escorted by the best man, Adam. Alright guys, here's this one we've all been waiting for. I want all of you up on your feet. If you got a drink in front of you or in your hand, why don't you raise that high in the air and go ahead and make some crazy noise, because it gives me the great pride and privilege to introduce to you our guest of honor, Mr. and Mrs. Justin Sorge.
This short and sweet, but I'm the kind of person who has to email their professor because my two-page maximum paper somehow ended up being 10 pages every single time. Seriously, that happens like literally every time. See, I'm already doing it now. So. But first of all, I just want to thank Elizabeth and Tim and Denise and Terry for making, for raising such wonderful hooligans. I can remember Bailey being my friend since the first grade, although she is convinced that I was too popular
to talk to her until like eighth grade. Clearly that's not true, but I just wanted to remind her in front of all of her friends and family how popular I was in middle school. I was pretty cool. Throughout the years, Bailey has been my rock, my best friend, my right hand, and my go-to. I honestly can't put into words how important she is to me. Not only am I lucky enough to have her as a smoking hot best friend, but she is the one person who is always there for me no matter what. Today is one of the happiest days of my life, and I cannot express how much I love you both. But saying goodbye to my best friend is one of the hardest things I've ever had to do in my life. I truly believe that God put you two together for a reason and that this is your happily ever after. However, what kind of best friend would I be if I didn't threaten Justin's life at least a little before I let you go? So on that note, Justin Sorge, let yourself be warned that everything you do, good and bad, will be sent to me in very detailed text messages. So when you leave the toilet seat up on July 18th at 9:02 p.m., I will know about it and I will not forget it. Just because you're taking my girl doesn't mean you're getting rid of me, like ever, ever. So here are some things I expect of you, Justin. Even, sorry, Bailey. Even when she's sleeping with her mouth wide open and snoring like a bear, make sure to kiss her good morning every day. When she's 4 hours late to dinner because it took her a year to do her makeup, don't be mad and make sure to tell her she looks beautiful. Surprise her with dark chocolate covered strawberries and a bottle of wine just because she deserves it. And lastly, for God's sake, get this woman a puppy. In all seriousness, though, I have complete faith in Justin as a husband, best friend, and a soulmate for Bailey. I have never saw her more happy and completely consumed by one person in my whole 15 years of knowing her. And to Bailey, thank you for being the most genuine, supportive, trustworthy, and awkward best friend I could ever ask for. I truly don't know what I'm supposed to do here without you. I am devastated that you're leaving me, but my complete excitement and adoration for your new life outweighs any sadness that I have. So Bailey, I hope you find wonderful new friends who let you get the good side in pictures, even though they always look like a potato on that side. Friends who go on spontaneous car rides and sing at the top of their lungs with the confidence of Taylor Swift, even though they sound more like a kids' bop CD. Friends who won't question how long you've gone without washing your hair because they know that's like only a weekly thing for you. Friends who get stopped by the cops for stalking some random boy's house in the middle of the night. Sorry, fam, that's a true story. And friends who let some random drunk guy kiss them just so they will leave you alone. Also, sorry, Dad. Bailey, I hope you find the most wonderful, caring friends everywhere your life takes you. Just don't let them be funnier than me or we're gonna have a problem. So let's raise our glasses to Bailey and Justin. Here is to a life full of happiness, love, adventure, and babies. Lots and lots of babies. Y'all can start popping those suckers out anytime now. So congratulations to the hottest newlywed couple this world has ever seen. We love you guys.
My name's Adam Sorge. I'm Justin's twin and better-looking brother. And for the next 45 minutes, I'm going to be the tour guide through the lives of Bailey Potter and Justin Sorge. The seemingly impossible relationship...
Whoa. No office references. None.
No office quotes?
None at all. Office-free zone.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. I guess I'll be up here for only 5 minutes, you guys. No more 45 minutes. You guys are off the hook for that one. Okay, so for as far back as I can remember, Justin has been a huge, huge role model in my life. He's a guy I've always looked up to. We're twin brothers. We've done absolutely everything together. We shared a room for the longest time. which is not as cool as you think it might be. Bunk beds are only, like, they get really uncomfortable, and it's not as good as you think it is. Just trust me on that one. I can remember one year when we were younger on our birthday, Justin, out of the goodness of his heart, decided to give me a present. And we're twins, so usually, like, we had the same birthday. Like, I mean, so we never really got, you know how that works? Yeah. We did. Usually, there were some days it wasn't like that. Right, right. Well, so, like, for our birthday, like, we had the same birthday, he decided to give me a gift one year, which I was really excited about. Like, wow, like, my brother's gonna give me a gift. That's awesome. So he gift wraps this gigantic, really not really special rock. It's a huge rock that he gift wrapped and gave to me for my birthday. This is something we used to fight over, like pretend like one of us had it, then we'd steal it from each other. But it wasn't really that cool. And so like he gives this rock to me and I open it up and I really, really try hard not to hide the look of disappointment on my face. I'm sorry, Justin, but I was young. I would have much rather had money or like a video game or something. But to this day, that rock is still in my room. Justin is someone I've always like loved, I've always looked up to, and he gave me a gift. He took the time to wrap it. As dumb as I thought it might have been, he took the time to give that gift to me. And so that I felt so special because of that. But it's like, and we were homeschooled. Did anyone know we were homeschooled? We were homeschooled. That explains a lot of my social awkwardness. Like, we were homeschooled till like sixth grade. So my social skills never really fully developed. So that explains a lot, I guess. But so sixth grade, we go to middle school. I don't know anybody. I have no way of talking to anybody. I was too awkward. But I always had Justin with me. He was my best friend until high school, when Justin became the popular guy, and I still stayed in my little shell, this little awkward thing. Justin was a football star. I played football, was not really a star though. Went to a school of about 130 people. I was third string, and I think I was the only one on third string. Everyone else was, yeah, so that's how that worked. But I still had Justin. We were a little rockier in high school. We weren't as close. I still looked up to him though. I'm not sure how much he knew that, but he really meant everything to me. He wouldn't let anyone pick on me. He could pick on me, but no one else could. That was like his thing. I remember one time, we went to school one day, and without knowing it, we wore the same shirt. And he goes to his friends, finds a shirt, and makes me take it off and change. So we're not matching the whole time. Because that would be too uncool, I guess. I don't know, but that's just how it was. And no matter what, though, we always had each other's backs, and that's just something I'm so grateful for. He's a great guy, and he's a leader. Like he's in the Air Force. If you couldn't tell by the uniform, that's an Air Force uniform. He does great things. He's an explosive ordnance disposal technician, which is more than I can really say. I'm not sure exactly what it does. He blows things up. That's pretty cool. And like I'm so proud of the way he is. He's a leader. He set an example. Him and Bailey's relationship is something that like I want in my life. Like the way that Bailey can handle Justin being away and the way Justin handles it, vice versa, it's inspiring. I know a lot of people that have tried that kind of relationship and they failed. And I don't know how you guys do it, but it's something special. When Justin told me he started dating Bailey, I was really excited. But I was even more excited when I actually got to see him face to face and see the way he lit up when he talked about Bailey. It was not just another girlfriend. This was someone that I knew that he would be with her forever. And I was really happy about that. And then I was at summer camp I think it was a year ago, was I there? And Justin writes me a letter and he asked me to be his best man at his wedding. And I remember sitting there just sobbing. I was so, so honored that Justin picked me to be his best man. Out of everyone he could have picked, he picked me. This guy I looked up to and held in such a high regard decided to make me a best man. And there's really no more honor in that. I'm so happy for that. I was really scared of messing it up. I don't know how I'm doing right now, but hopefully I'm making you proud, Justin. I mean, you really, like, you're my best friend. I can talk to you about anything, and I'm so happy that you chose me. I'm proud of who you are. I'm proud of you and Bailey. Bailey, you. Hope you know what you're getting yourself into, because Justin is one stubborn guy. I don't know if you know that or not, but he is. And, don't make that face. You are. You know you are. But one word of advice for you guys, make sure that you always keep God the center of your relationship, because as long as he's there, you both are striving to pursue God and pointing each other towards God, then things will work out. And please just keep doing that. Don't forget the love you guys have. Don't forget how special you guys feel tonight. Even when it's tough, just remember that you guys have a special love, and I'm really happy for you guys. Thank you. So wait. Don't clap. Don't stop clapping. We're going to raise our glasses. Thank you, DJ, for reminding me. We're going to raise our glasses as a toast to Justin and Bailey. We love you guys. Let's take a drink. Clink.
So I dance.
Unforgettable moment for Bailey and her father. Together for Justin and his mother.
Thank you.
the better driver. No peeking, baby. Okay. After an argument, who was the first to apologize? Nice, nice. You guys been making yet? Okay. First to admit that they were in love. All right. Who's smarter? He says neither, she says both. It's up for debate. It's up for debate. Who is funnier? Well played, Justin. Well played. Out of the two of you, which one of you is clumsy? That was a quick answer. Who talks the most? Would you like a lifeline? All right. Whose car is the cleanest?
Not really.
No debate there. Okay. This is a good one. I apologize. Who has the crazier family?
Careful.
What?
Who is the better singer? Okay. What about better dancer? All right, not gifted in those areas, huh? Okay. Who's a pickier eater? Should make for some interesting dinners. Who will be in charge of the money? Wow. All right. Who's the better cook? I like it. Okay. Who is more likely to burn down the kitchen while they cook? She hasn't cooked, but she's more likely. Okay. Who is the stubborn one? First to forget, but the stubborn one. Oh, interesting. Okay, who's the daredevil? This one's an easy one. Who looks better today? All right, and the last question, just in honor of the game itself. And sometimes this is a surprising answer. Who has the most shoes? Okay, you'd be surprised. All right, does anybody else have a question? I'll give you guys five crowd questions. Oh, wow. There's one. We have any others?
Who cleans the most?
Who cleans the most? Cooks and cleans. You got yourself a gem there. All right, two more.
Who's the fastest?
Race.
Yeah, in a foot race. Who would win a foot race? Pretty easy. Okay. All right, one more. Make it a good one. Who's got one?
Who's a better kisser?
All right, let's give it up for these two. Let's give it up for these two. Big guest points.
Oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said, shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny. She said, ooh, ooh, shut up and dance with me. We were victims of the night. The chemical, physical,
you dare back, just keep